Let's just listen into Ajay Maken of the Congress. Is he, as he admits,
जनता का जो निर्णय है लोकतंत्र के अंदर वो सर्वोपरि होता है, सर्वमान्य होता है, और जनता का जो जनादेश इन चुनावों के जरिए हम सब लोगों को मिला है, हम लोग बधाई देना चाहेंगे अरविंद केजरीवाल जी को और उम्मीद करेंगे कि जो वायदे उन्होंने किए हैं, जो सपने उन्होंने इस चुनाव के दौरान और पहले जिन सपनों को रेखांकित किया है, उन सपनों को जरूर दिल्ली के अंदर पूरा करेंगे, उन वायदों को जरूर पूरा करेंगे। लोकतंत्र की भलाई के लिए, लोकतंत्र की और मजबूती के लिए मैं दिल से ही इच्छा करता हूं कि उन वायदों को वो जरूर पूरा कर पाएंगे। आज चुनाव के नतीजे के बाद में जिस तरीके से रुझान आ रहे हैं, मैंने कल भी कहा था और आज भी मैं उसको दोहराना चाहूंगा कि दिल्ली के अंदर आज दिल्ली के अंदर चुनाव के आप सब लोगों को बोला तो हुआ था कि भी कितने बजे आएंगे, तो आप लोग
क्लियरली द कांग्रेस हैज you know, has admitted defeat. What's been a terrible day for the Congress at the office. Ragini Nair, you can give whatever spin you want. But my worry for the Congress party, just as my worry for the BJP, is that the BJP may see this as a Delhi verdict only and not see any national implication whatsoever, that the Congress party will see this as, you know, eventually we will come back, it's Mr. Modi's defeat, and you will clutch at straws. You know, the Manishankar airline, this is Modi's defeat. It's also Congress's debacle. But you are ruling this city
that's
for 15
what I said,
years.
Isn't it? I mean, can you really...
Did you make a mistake? For example, let me give you one example. Yeah. Sheila Dixit, not even brought into the campaign. The most popular face that the Congress has had, you just sent her into a retirement home.
But why do you think we didn't bring her into the campaign? She was working at her own pace. She was pretty much visible in New Delhi, isn't it? And she was there in the Badarpur rally of Srimati Sonia Gandhi. I mean, you can't say that she wasn't brought into the picture, but she wanted to move ahead with her own pace.
What
but
is wrong with your party? Something seems to be gone. You've lost the support of the Muslim. You've lost the Muslim vote. You've lost the Dalit vote. You've lost the urban poor. This was your traditional constituency. What has gone wrong?
You've lost the intellectual vote. You've lost.
Is it a credibility question? People don't trust you anymore.
I think it's a combination of so many things, and we have to do a sort of an analysis of that, which is going to take some time. But let me tell you, I mean, how can a party survive without optimism, Rajdeep? You can't say that if we've lost, I mean, only after a disaster can you resurrect. Right. And the Congress has proven its mettle quite many times. In 77, similar sort of stance was taken by most of the critics. And from that, from there on also, we rose from the ashes like the phoenix, and we're going to
you
do that.
You had Indira Gandhi, then, you had Mrs. Gandhi.
We have capable leadership right now. But there's one point I want to make.
The resurrection.
Are you serious about elections?
The five elections.
Yes.
You see, I mean, one victory, one defeat, you cannot write Congress off. I mean, the country was created into a nation state, modern nation state by the Congress party. Yeah, and you cannot say that the Congress has become irrelevant just because you've lost a few elections. I'm not going to say that we haven't made mistakes. We have made mistakes, but we are ready to make amends.
One by one. Okay.
I just want to ask one.
Yeah.
What would have to happen?
Please be fair on the ladies.
What would have to happen for the Congress to be considered irrelevant? Tell me one result. Tell me something that I can put my hands on. What would have to have happened?
What? How much?
That the Congress gets less than zero seats? What needs to happen for us to conclude?
We need to start winning elections, is what you're saying.
Not winning. Winning some seats.
What are you trying to say? You're trying to say that we've got zero seats in Delhi would mean that
we've got zero seats everywhere.
No, that's not the case. You mean to say that we will never be able to come back to power? We will never be able to win back the hearts of the people of Delhi. I don't agree with that. We are ready to make amends. We are ready to. We are committed. No.
Hold on.
We are committed to get to restore the ground which we lost. And no. This kind of an attack. This kind. I will have to be very.
Don't think of coming back to power. Think of just building.
I said winning back the hearts of the people is the most important thing that
it's a long-term process.
Yes.
Okay.
But another point that I want to make, because I have to leave after this.
Yes.
You see, there seems to be a sort of a unanimity over the fact that the invincibility myth of Mr. Modi and the BJP has been subverted by the Aam Aadmi Party, at least in Delhi. But I think the Aam Aadmi Party also has to learn a lesson. If this could happen to the Modi wave during, within a span of eight months, the similar thing could also happen with the Aam Aadmi Party if they don't deliver.
Point
the
taken.
Votes which have tactfully have been shifted. The anti-Modi votes which have been shifted to the Aam Aadmi Party. The Congress sympathizers who have gone to the Aam Aadmi Party.
May I also, and I want to
be able to retain the seats if they don't start delivering.
Look at the numbers. 66.
That's what somebody just messaged me.
Now, you know, if it is 70-0-0, I think we all need to go under the table and wonder what kind of an election is.
Then.
You know, look, at the end of the day, this is a wipeout. I'm just going to leave it.
BJP plus.
I'm just going to, as we go into the break, Manini, since you're leaving us, just one point. Bihar could take place in 2 months. It could take place in 8 months. And you could have Narendra Modi and the BJP win again, right? Am I to understand that every state election is different?
No.
Why are we now going beyond that?
I'll tell you, this has a huge significance. Because it's Delhi.
Yes.
Let's not kid ourselves. This is not Andaman, Nicobar Islands, Port Blair municipal election. Even a Port Blair municipal election would have repercussions after Modi's wave. It's going to have immediate repercussions because Mr. Modi himself said the world is watching. It is going to have repercussions of the international. Mm-hmm. Mr. Obama has already given these gentle hints about, India's secularism and tolerance.
Mm-hmm.
Many, many more voices will come. For the first 6 months, the world and India were sort of absolutely mesmerized by this person who had come. So that factor is gone. The invincibility factor is gone. I'm saying immediately, I think the PDP-BJP talks in J&K, PDP will have a much bigger bargaining
position. I was told the government is to be formed on the 20th of February. Will it be formed or not now?
No. Maybe, I don't know, I'm just thinking aloud. I'm saying the immediate repercussion, what politics is. You know, when people are up, everyone's quiet. When you see a chink in the armor, everyone, sorry, the budget. Now, there are sections, not just the Hindutva in terms of Ghar Vapsi, there are sections like the Swadeshi Jagran Manj, Bharatiya Kisan Sangh, who are very unhappy with the land law ordinance, with a lot of the reformist agenda of, so the budget might be affected.
Okay.
We are going to see a whole lot of effect on this. It's just not a local Delhi election.
Okay. That's-